Good afternoon, South Africa. Welcome to Afternoon Express. I'm Bonnie Mbuli. I'm rolling solo today, but you will be entertained. Today is a classic Thursday in the loft, which means fashion, beauty, and luxury. Leading up to SA Fashion Week starting tonight, we chat to fashion designer Orapelo Ngundutle. Plus, we chat to anti-aging later on with some experts, and we look at the latest technology in salon treatment. And we haven't forgotten about your dose of culinary inspiration. And today we're making two great dishes. First up, we're putting a twist on a traditional bread by adding yogurt. For a list of ingredients and a link to that recipe, SMS the keyword bread to 33650. SMSs are R1.50 each and free SMSs don't apply. Then later we'll be making a comforting seafood curry as well. But our first guest today, Lois Mkhize, started his career as a designer, illustrator and fine artist. After becoming well renowned for his incredible surreal portraits, Lois opened a whole new avenue in his career when he created South Africa's first unique superhero comic, Kwezi. A character who has captured the hearts of young South Africans all over the country. Now in the loft is the man himself, Lois Mkhize. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
I love the hair.
Yeah, apparently.
Was that your idea?
No, absolutely not. A good friend said it might look good, so I'm trying out something new.
Well, your friend was right. Yeah, so you started drawing when you were young, and your classmates used to pay you R5 a drawing to draw comic characters for them?
Yeah, it's actually an interesting story. It's quite classic because my parents weren't too happy about me extorting money from little kids while I was a kid as well for drawing Bugs Bunny or something.
Well, good for you. Because, I mean, what were you going to do? Just draw pictures all day for free?
Exactly. I mean, they had to get paid somehow. Well, it was either R5 or lunch, you know, someone else's lunch, so pretty much worked out.
And how would you draw? I mean, would you just draw just to memory?
Would you capture pictures
in your mind and draw them?
No. I mean, from yay high, I was always into comic books, as well as, you know, the Disney cartoon characters. So whatever I watched on television, I, you know, replicated on a piece of paper. So I suppose it's a photographic memory, if you will, but yeah, I mean, it's a talent. You grow up with it, you really can't explain where it comes from, but
And to that talent, you decided to add education, right? And how did you figure this is something that you could make money out of? This is something that was going to be lucrative? Or what were your thoughts going in to study it? Because I think a lot of young people find themselves torn between, do I do something that I love or do
especially
I find something to study
attached,
that I can make money at?
Yeah, of course there's stigmas attached to going into art or visual arts, to be specific.
Absolutely.
But luckily I have this mother who put me on at a very young age. She'd be like, oh, mtana mzabane mali. So it was like, so you can imagine a seven-year-old growing up with that type of, you know, feedback. It did well for my own self-esteem as an artist. So
absolutely.
I never at all had a doubt that I'd end up being an artist at all. And I mean, they were great because they, you know, exposed me to stuff. Grahamstown Arts Festival, again, I'm from the Eastern Cape, right?
Yes,
whatever outlet we got or however way they could expose me to art, they did.
Yeah.
Did quite a good job.
And then you were confident and daring enough to approach the comic book Super Strikers, which is famous all over Africa, and you got offered a position.
Yeah.
What did you learn from that experience that you were later going to use in your own comic book?
Well, I suppose when I was much younger, I mean, I always wanted to be a comic book artist because I'd see these comic books, you know, Superman, Spider-Man, and I'd always figured that this is what I wanted to do. Luckily for me, when I got to Cape Town, a mate of mine tells me that, you know, the Super Striker studios are in Cape Town and I'd have to go and check them out.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously, went out on a limb, showed them my stuff without, you know, organizing an interview beforehand. And the next day I had a job.
Oh, good for you.
And it was important because, you know, you want to hone your skills, right? Mm-hmm. You want to have some sort of professionalism and understanding of the industry at a very young age so that you can, you know, take on the industry in your own way, you know, a couple of years later. So as far as, you know, my relationship with that company as well as my growth there, it was more about honing my skills.
Yeah,
and understanding the industry, and which was great. I mean, I'm always grateful for that experience.
Absolutely. Now, I was stalking your Instagram page earlier and I realized you were very drawn to portraits.
Yeah.
And what is it about the portraits that is important for you to capture? Because, I mean,
it's a very loaded thing, and I suppose I'm very inclined to painting people. Because I, you know, whenever I engage people, I understand, or at least see stories behind, you know, whether it be, you know, just from conversation, just looking at them, there's always something to tell. And for the most part, the people that I represent in the paintings, I always feel their story needs to be told. And portraiture, particularly portrait paintings, I mean, there's such a nice, you know, it's such an elegant way of telling stories, right? There's something about it that, you know, you almost eternalize the subjects, right?
Wow.
It's so timeless, and it really sparked a definite sentiment to me.
Yeah.
And I figured, you know, particularly these people, you know, people that look like me, who otherwise historically never had a chance to be, you know, looked at and celebrated.
And represented in the best way.
Absolutely.
Yes. And I see there's an element of kind of magic, fantasy, an ethereal nature. Mm. What is that about?
Well, I'll tell you what. For me, I believe I'm part of a generation that is redefining our identity as Africans, right?
Mm-hmm.
And a part of that requires us to have some sort of imagination, some sort of thinking of ourselves in a different way. And when I'm able to do that through my art, I'm able to exercise that muscle through my paintings, where I try and re-envision who I am, first and foremost.
Yeah.
And then what I'd like to see in the future. The people that I paint, I celebrate them.
I elevate them and
make them larger than life, to sort of create a radical presence about these black bodies that finally have a platform to be looked at.
Yeah.
And not in a negative way at all, but perhaps in a very progressive and powerful way.
Yeah. Well, that comes across very clearly in your work. Yeah. Now, you illustrate and founded a comic book called Kwezi, a comic character. Who's Kwezi? Tell us about him.
Oh, man. It's like, it always feels like I've got a split personality, because in one sense I'm painting portraits and now I'm doing Kwezi. Again, Kwezi is a superhero comic book.
Mm-hmm.
And it stemmed from, you know, a longing that I had as a very young kid, reading all these, the Marvel comic books, DC comic books. And always, I mean, I suppose when I was 16, I always wondered what a South African superhero would be like, you know. Could we even imagine what that would look like? And I pondered and played with the idea for years, you know, and it always seemed like someone would do it. That was the thing. I always figured, you know, someone out there who's way ahead in their own careers would finally do it, but it never came. Luckily, right? So, I decided, I think it was late 2012, that, you know what, I've been working now at Super Strikers, again, honing my skill and understanding the industry. Well, then obviously I figured that, okay, fine, I've gotten to a point now where I have the capacity, the talent, as well as the skill, just to take that idea further that I've had since I was 16. It was time that Kwezi came alive.
So
I started very, the typical stuff, you know, drawing this character that wore spandex. First drawing he was wearing spandex and a cape. It looked really ridiculous because I was obviously trying to imitate from the West.
Seen,
right?
Yeah.
But I actually realized very quickly that I'd have to keep it strictly South African and proudly South African, and that was the turning point. I think that's what makes it so unique as well.
Oh, yeah. Well, you guys should check out Kwezi. He's very, very interesting. And I've met many intelligent men who always tell me that when they were young, they read comic books. So I'm going to encourage my little boys to read comic books more often.
Definitely.
We asked you out there what your thoughts were on choosing a career to make money, or following your dreams, or following a career because you love it. And Matlatsi Lawrence Mohale says, afternoon, I think one should just go to career to make money? And Mutlatsi says, it depends on the situation, but I'd rather prefer to follow my dreams. Thank you so much. We'll be reading more of your comments later. After the break, it's Art in the Kitchen as we put an interesting twist on a traditional bread recipe by adding yogurt. So stay right where you are. Welcome back to Afternoon Express, live on SABC3. I'm in the kitchen now and we're about to make yogurt bread with Clem.
Yeah, for me, the simplest things in life make me happy.
Absolutely.
Bread and butter is all I need in life. Okay, maybe with a glass of wine. But bread for me is the most satisfying
It's
recipe.
A daily need, right?
It is.
But you know what, when it comes to bread in the kitchen, it's so intimidating. Like, whenever people talk about making bread, I'm always thinking, not for me.
Really?
So I hope you're going to make it easy.
It
for
was
me
the
today.
First recipe I ever learned to make.
Really?
Ever. Yeah. And it really
Well, you're
is...
a true chef.
No, but the thing is, everybody needs to know how to make a bread.
I no, think no, so.
So
true.
You and I are going to talk.
Okay.
Can I pass the sugar? Let me just grab for you. So this is a really, really easy bread, and it's using yogurt as the liquid. The liquid that brings all the ingredients together.
Okay.
And it's so surprising that it's not used more often because yogurt is full of cultures, live cultures.
Yes.
And bread is all about the yeast and live cultures inside the bread.
Yeah.
So this is actually a cheat way how to create a sourdough. Very easily,
very easily, and
it's very simply greeted. So in my mixer, I've got some flour.
Right.
To that, I'm going to add that yeast, and I'm using just a sachet of dried yeast. You don't have to. You can get the brewer's yeast, which you can find in stores now, which is really great.
Really,
but the dried yeast is perfectly fine.
Okay.
Then in goes some sugar, and what I've got here is I've got some salt, and this is my tip when it comes to seasoning your bread. I always dilute the salt in water. If you add grains of salt to your bread, you can think about those grains don't really break up. So you get little bits of salt.
Yeah.
By diluting it in the water, it gets evenly transferred through the bread immediately.
Okay.
So in goes the salt water, and then I'm going to turn it off. And if you can pass me amazing yogurt.
The yogurt.
So this yogurt is great. It's new on shelves right now. It's the new released yogurt from Woolies. It's their plain yogurt. It is absolutely delicious.
Thick and creamy.
And it's preservative-free, which is
insane.
And also, there's more live cultures in here than you're going to find in any other yogurt on the shop, which is why I had to use it in a bread. So if you can pass my little spatula on the side, I'm going to get that in there. This is the real deal. This stuff is amazing. So we're going to get that in there. Let me actually just lift up the machine and be a lot easier. And so this is, normally you would add water to your mixture now, or eggs and a little bit of oil.
And I know bread is quite temperamental, so does the yogurt have to be room temperature?
Not at all. It can be cold,
so
it can be warm.
You can take it from cold. Just put it in there.
As is. This is so like a fuss-free recipe. What's also great is the sugar quantities and the salt quantities you can play around with in this recipe. So make it your own.
Okay.
It's a very forgiving bread recipe. So you're going to bring that all together. You're going to think that this is going to need more mixture, some more liquid. Don't add it. It's gonna look very dry, but eventually it comes together. It actually becomes a very wet dough. So this comes together in the bowl, not everywhere else. Comes together.
Yes, I see this.
makes a beautiful ball of dough, and you're gonna rest it for 2 hours.
2 hours.
What you're gonna end up with is this beauty over here. If you can pass that to me.
This looks so beautiful. Look how fluffy it is. It's moving.
It is, because it's alive.
Wow, look at
that. It's alive. It's the truth. So I'm going to actually give you the honors of punching. Oh, you've actually like already knocked it down slightly.
Did I knock it down?
Like, you can actually see how wet it is. It is super wet.
It is.
Don't be tempted to add any flour to
it. It smells beautiful.
It smells
yeasty. Yeast and that yogurt.
Am I right?
You got that. Like sourdough bread already.
And that's such a cheat. Sourdough normally takes days to make.
Yeah.
Days.
Yeah.
We made it in like a couple of hours. So what you're gonna do now is,
here's where things get a bit.
It's a life hack. It's not cheating. So here's where things get quite a little different.
Yeah.
I've got this beautiful cast iron pot, and I heat it up in the oven at 220 degrees for 30 minutes. So it's gonna be screaming hot.
Okay.
While this is nice and risen, what I do is, I grease my pot.
Pour that in there.
Yeah. I pour it into the pot.
Yeah.
Lid on. And then put it back into the oven for half an hour.
Back in the oven.
Back in the oven for another half an hour. You're going to get this beautiful crust on it. I mean, after half an hour,
you can only make it in a pot like this, a cast iron.
You can make it in the oven without the pot.
Yeah.
The reason for the pot is you get a beautiful
moisture.
And crust. The crust on this bread is really insane, and you want that. So you take the lid off, and you end up with this beauty.
With this beauty.
So it's nice and dark as it's supposed to be, because the sourdoughs are dark. So I've got some butter for you there if you like.
I would just break that.
Look at that. The crust is essential when it comes to a sourdough. Yes, you can break it.
Looks beautiful.
In some religions, it's actually you don't slice bread, you break it.
You break it?
You have to.
Okay.
So let's just break it, please. And you got some delicious bread. I got some butter if you want to try it.
No, yeah, we definitely need a whole lot of butter in this. While I apply some butter, do remember that the keyword to this recipe is bread. SMS the keyword to 33650 for the link to the recipe and the ingredients. SMSs cost R1.50. No free SMSs apply. But if you missed any of this recipe, here's a quick recap. Thank you so much for all your lovely comments on our Facebook page. We asked you, what would you prefer, or what do you think one should choose, a career for money or a career for love or to follow their dreams? And Lerato Mafa says, I believe in following dreams because we'll end up hating going to work. Hashtag love your work, do not put money first. And I agree with you. Kelly says, making dreams come true has always been a bigger picture of achievement. I'll follow my dreams and turn it into reality. Nice one. Mbali says, following your dreams saves you from a lot, like waking up every day to do something you don't even enjoy doing. That's true. Mokhotle says, I'll certainly follow my dreams, and my reward toward my dreams will be money. That's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for all your comments. After the break, it's fashion, fashion, fashion as we sit down with renowned designer Orapeleng Modutle. Welcome back to Afternoon Express. And if you've just joined us, it's a Thursday, so we're talking all things fashion and beauty. SA Fashion Week kicks off in Cape Town this evening. And joining us today is renowned designer and entrepreneur, Orapeleng Modutle, a man who has dressed some of the country's biggest stars like Bonang Matheba, Mini Dlamini, Thando Thabete, are just a few on the list. And today he's brought some of his creations along with him. Welcome to the love.
Thank you very much for having me.
Yeah,
How are you?
Very chic.
Thank you.
Is that one of your creations?
No, actually, I got this from Zara.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. I mean, do you design stuff for yourself sometimes?
I do, yeah. Especially when I've got shows or when I have to attend a wedding or something, then I throw myself something to do quickly, fast.
So your mom was one of the inspirations for why you got into fashion. Why?
Yeah, so when I grew up, my mother and my grandmother, they did a lot of hand stitching, hand needlework. So I also kind of formed part of the crew.
The crew.
Yes. And then later on, it developed into sketches.
Wow.
And I knew I wanted to become a fashion designer. So in my matric year, I went to a career exhibition. That's when I saw different institutions that offer the career that I wanted to do, and then I took it from there.
Yeah, and it seems gone are those days when a fashion designer can get by just being talented and making beautiful designs. You also have to be an entrepreneur.
Absolutely.
And is this something that you learnt as you studied, or did you have to go and find internships to do perhaps?
Yeah, so in institutions, they really teach you the skill. They give you a bit of the business, but when you go, after I finished, when I was in my final year, we have to do a work integrated learning. So I got an opportunity to be with Stone Cherry.
Oh, and we love Stone Cherry.
Yeah, Ken Sani, absolutely wonderful.
Yeah.
And just the experience that I got from her, she really taught me how to run a business, take a fashion, your career and your dream, and then turning it into a business, because there's different departments like the finances, your PRs, your HR, there's a whole lot of things that you need to know before you start your own business.
Yes. And then you started Orapeleng Modutle Style Avenue. Now, it's interesting for me, you called it a style avenue. There's obviously a huge difference between style and fashion, but what is it for you?
For us, it's really we offer our clients a whole package. It's an avenue where we give you a hat, a pair of shoes and a bag, and what makeup to wear and what hair to do. Yes. So it's just definitely just telling you, no, you can use this couple. Or we also have distribution chin partner, sorry, yeah. like makeup artists like Clara Banks. And we've got an amazing guy called Sean in Pretoria who does our hair. So it's just really like telling you what to do and how to wear our stuff just yeah. to execute it the way we want it to look.
Fashion design is such a competitive field.
Excellent.
How do you make sure that you're always basically just honing your skill and also finding a voice that stands out where people see an Orapeleng design and they know it's his and they want it for a particular reason? What do you think stands out about your designs?
I think when I started my business in 2013, I started with ready to wear. And I really started knowing and getting an attraction of the woman I wanted to dress, who is very feminine, luxury, romantic. She
Yay.
Travels a lot. She exudes opulence. So that's immediately once you find the kind of dress, the woman you want to dress, it becomes very easy because you know what they want, what they like to wear, what they like to show, what they like to enhance. And then just everything just becomes a whole one big package
yeah.
that the clients want.
So today you've brought us tidbits from your different lines over the years.
Yes.
And why did you choose these particular pieces?
Some are from 2014 and then some are from 2016. So.
Yeah.
Those are the outfits that mainly celebrities worn, like
yes.
your Bonangs and your Minis.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, awesome. I'm sure everyone would love to see them. Show us what you've got. Okay.
So this is from our previous collection, the Autumn, Winter, Spring, Summer, last
this
year in Joburg.
Gorgeous.
So we decided to do a two-piece. For someone who goes to the beach, when someone is having a party in the beach or something.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes,
you know,
hosting.
Then you want to stand out from the crowd and then do your typical swimsuit.
If you don't plan to swim as well.
Yeah, absolutely, because those are beads, hand-beaded, so that's just
oh,
for
that's
looking great.
Oh, that's
yes.
Are those glass beads?
Glass beads and Swarovski crystals and
Ooh,
all of that.
Very opulent. Okay, so what do we have next?
And this is from our spring-summer collection in 2015. This was worn by Nomza Mombata at
yeah.
the Metros last year.
Yes.
So this is just more really for your reception gown.
Uh-huh.
And some you can just like swap it around and maybe for a traditional wedding and then you just put Zulu beads
yes.
or Ndebele beads. Just.
I mean, I personally love a white dress. I'll wear a white dress anyway, but I see more and more designers and wearers of your designs are becoming more brave wearing white, when
yeah.
they're not getting married.
Yeah.
Right.
It's a trend.
It's become a trend. Beautiful on the red carpet.
Absolutely.
So what do we have here?
So this is it's also from our last year collection. It was worn by Pearl Mudiadia. So this is when you can wear it as a reception gown. So when you accessorize it with this hat from Anita Ferreira, which is one of the collaborations that we're having for the show.
So you do a lot of hand beading and embroidery,
yeah.
I see.
It's quite intensive labor.
Yes.
And, yeah. Because we want to stand out from the crowd.
Absolutely.
And really, yeah, and then just wear very for a nice hat.
The back is beautiful.
Absolutely.
Gorgeous.
And then you wear that with the back and then go to the polo, you look stunning.
Absolutely. Cool, what do we have next? I think this is quite a famous dress,
yeah, this
right?
Is. Quite famous. So this is also from our last year spring summer collection that was worn by Bonang Motheba for the Glam Africa mag cover.
Mm.
Yes. So this is really for your mother of the bride, Sicilian,
for a
reception.
An edgy mother
yeah,
of the
for
bride.
A very edgy mother
yeah.
of the bride. Someone who's very rich and who likes to look fabulous. And yeah, you can wear it to a garden wedding and you can wear it to a polo. Yeah.
Wow, okay, awesome. So what can we expect for your showing at the Fashion Week?
So I'm doing Autumn Winter Collection, which is a rose garden wedding.
Ooh.
So royalty is getting married and they have invited all their elite clients and close family to come. So it's a whole different world of fantasy. So people must look out for that. It's going to
yeah.
be quite amazing.
Well, I'm going to definitely look out for it. Thank you so much for all your social media comments. I'm looking for our iPad rather. We asked you whether one should choose a career for money or for the love of it. And you've definitely chosen for the love of it, right? And Busi Janki says, I believe to follow your dream and passion over everything. Once you do it for money, at some point you're stuck in a career that does not make you happy. And being unhappy with what you do not only steals happiness, but also affects how productive you are. That's so true. You can always find a way to fund and sustain yourself from living your dream. And Young Prince says, I've turned my dreams into my career, being an actor and rapper. First of all, you have to be committed in what you love and do your best in it. In the end, it pays your bills, insurance, etc. Hashtag Young Prince the Artist. Thank you so much. Those are all true and they definitely resonate. Coming up after the break, we turn our focus to the latest technology in anti-aging. Today, we look at some of the newest salon experiences available. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, women love a little time out to pamper themselves. And a facial can be a relaxing and important treatment in our skincare regime. Today, we are joined by NMU spokesperson Heidi Serfontein and International Education Manager Eunice Bredenkamp about the benefits of facials and the advantages of the NMU Age Intelligence Range. Welcome, ladies. Last time we chatted, we spoke about the NMU Age Intelligence retail range. But today, I want to speak about the professional range. And of course, you brought the NMU Spa into our loft. What kind of professional products are there on offer?
Right, so firstly, NMU has a variety of professional treatments. Yeah. So it is definitely based on what the needs of the clients are that we would decide what specific treatment to do. So as we are focusing on the NMU Age Intelligent range, we would actually really focus on what we can do as a professional treatment to support that and help the client to maintain the results at home. So there are many other products as retail that would support the professional treatments. And today we're going to be looking at the NMU SRC treatments.
Okay, amazing. Now, how important is it to have regular facials?
Oh, it's very important, Jeannie. You said earlier that it's a relaxing pamper must-have, but there's so much more to it than that.
I know.
We have to look at, we can now support the client in her home care regime. So she will purchase expensive home care products, but what does she do further on? Yeah. So coming to the salon, we can focus on hyperpigmentation, we can focus on anti-age, of course, acne, and even sensitized skin. You have to think of it as exercise. If I want to lose weight and I only go on a diet, I will lose weight and I will look much better. But if I join a health club and I have an exercise regime as well, I will also build my muscle, so it will be beneficial to my body and my weight loss. Same with my treatments. Great home care complements salon treatments. Great salon treatments complement home care.
Now, this is usually a 45-minute treatment, and it's obviously quite luxurious and relaxing when we aren't present. Sorry about that. But what exactly is the procedure?
Well, this is Zona. She's our client today.
Hi,
we are focusing on the NMU SRC treatment. It's a skin resurfacing complex, and specifically the one for environmentally damaged skin. It's very important that every therapist starts her treatment with a thorough skin analysis. Mm. That way, we don't only determine the needs of the client and what we can do for her, the long-term result, but we also determine her requirements. What does she want from this? Sometimes what we think they should have is not necessarily what they want or expect from a treatment. So on Zona, when I did my analysis, she suffers from environmentally damaged skin, early signs of aging, sagging, a bit of lines and wrinkles around the eye and lip area. And this treatment, complementary to our AI range, will be perfect for
her. But you're still beautiful.
Of course she is. Of course she is.
But once you know what the client needs, what's the next step from there?
Well, the treatment, as you said, is 45 minutes.
Yes.
It's very important to do a thorough exfoliation process. So NMU has a variety of processes, so we will again determine according to her need what exfoliation we will do. Then we will determine what SRC. But now, every client's different. So we can adapt our treatments to every client's specific needs. We might decide to do a course of 6 ED treatments.
Yeah.
Or we might maybe look at her pigmentation and do alternative treatments. 1 month we'll focus on anti-age and then bring in a pigmentation section. Or microneedling. So there's so much we can do. And then, of course, we have our transdermal solutions that we apply in every professional treatment under our mask or under our actives so that we can actually enhance the treatment even further that they, of course, continue with at home.
Now, how does the AI range then fit into the SRC treatment?
Well, with the AI range focusing on the anti-aging, it is the perfect fit for someone like Zona that is having the NIMU SRC treatment for environmentally damaged skin. So it's focusing on the aging, as Eunice was speaking about, but also there are other offerings with regards retail that the client can use at home to also complement and maintain the results that they have achieved in the salon.
Now, I absolutely love going for a facial, and on the day it looks amazing, but after treatment is also very important.
Yes.
So what's the after treatment with this?
After treatment is your home care. We would recommend that a client complements these treatments by coming obviously for regular treatments, but also by using the right home care range. Now, we offer a variety of treatments, as Heidi's mentioned, but we also have a variety of home care products. We can adapt a treatment or a home care regime by just changing an eye care product or adding something for the neck. And then, of course, we can also focus on men and youth. So we don't only look after the ladies, we like to look after clients in general. And whatever we do in South Africa with NIMU, we obviously interact this internationally with our international clients.
Amazing. So you're still getting all of the benefits from the salon treatment and, of course, from the home treatment.
Absolutely.
I'm ready to kick you out of that bed and swap places if you want. But for any of our viewers, if they want more information and if they want to access these products, where should they go?
Well, obviously, there are many NIMU salons countrywide, and the viewers can actually go there to be able to have a consultation with the therapist or to just receive further information. Alternatively, they can also visit the NIMU website as well as the NIMU app, and they'll be able to receive information not only on the NIMU Age Intelligent range, but also the other offerings that we have with NIMU. So there's lots that they can actually get from those platforms.
Well, Eunice and Heidi, you girls are so beautiful, and thank you so much for sharing all of this amazing beauty information with us today. Now, there you have it. Skincare results that you can see for yourself. Now, aging doesn't have to be scary if you have cutting-edge technology in your favor. So take these ladies' advice and visit a NIMU salon in your area soon.
Love is certainly one of the most powerful emotions, and this year, Revlon, the iconic beauty brand that's all about love, will continue to inspire us to make that bold move, to act rather than wait, and to choose love. Bonang Matheba recently shared her love story and what love means to her. Let's see how it all went down.
Well, this new Revlon love story is about choosing love, acting on your emotions. We used to tell you that love is on, now we're telling women all over the world to choose love and be fearless and be brave in celebrating love, receiving love, and believing that they're worthy of love. I love love stories. I think every single girl does in the whole wide world. And I think I've never had the opportunity to talk about my love story, so here's a wonderful way of doing it. On set, the experience has been absolutely amazing. You know, what you see today is a couple of hours of weeks and weeks of pre-production, weeks and weeks of work. You know, the Revlon team have done an incredible job in putting, you know, the set together, the lights. There's a lot of things that happen before we come on set, but I mean, set is always just so fun. It's an early morning, surrounded by lots of love. There's a lot of red roses, a lot of refreshments. It's hard work, but I think at the end of the day, when you see the finished product, you know, you sort of pat yourself on the back, like, yeah, man, we did good.
So the look I went for today is a bronzy gold look for our eyes. We've got a beautiful, clean, dewy skin with a bit of rosy cheek because we're trying to go for like a summer, clean, you know, Revlon's all about very classy, sassy, hence we threw in the gold. She's got a beautiful full lip, and normally with a full lip, when you wear color, it accentuates the lip, so it makes it bigger. So she likes a nude lip, which works very well for her because it gives her a very sensual, soft look. And I personally feel like it works because it's a very high fashion look.
Love means a lot of things to me. Love means giving love unconditionally. Love means receiving love unconditionally. Love means celebrating yourself, feeling confident, being powerful, feeling beautiful, feeling sexy. Love is about having the opportunity to make somebody else feel like that. Confidence and empowerment and freedom, I think, are really results of somebody who has been surrounded by love, somebody who is loved, somebody who feels so loved that it kind of changes the person that they are. It changes how they feel about themselves. And with that comes a lot of empowerment, comes a lot of self-confidence, comes a lot of self-esteem. And I always say love is a foundation for many things, but also love is the most powerful emotion in the world. I choose love by being love. You know, love is a feeling, but choosing it is an action. And there's something about love that emancipates a woman, like she can do and conquer anything. That's the power of love. I think I made the decision to be a little bit more fearless, and I'm glad I did that. When you realize that the person you're with is willing to defend you in front of millions of people, it's a different level of love, a different kind of relationship. But for me, it really is this small, intimate moments that people don't see when it's just him and I. There's nothing as wonderful as choosing love and then love choosing you right back.
To stand a chance to win one of three Revlon hampers of Bonang's Love Story look, go to our Twitter page and tell us how you boldly choose love, and make sure you use the hashtag ChooseLove. T's and C's apply and are available on afternoonexpress.co.za. And speaking of love, we asked you a question earlier asking, what would you choose, or what do you think one should choose, a career for love or for money? And thank you so much for sending us all your Facebook comments. Mashinta Cafe says, definitely dreams. Joe Elamu says, I forgot whom. Okay, that was a dad. Lerato Chauke says, I'd rather follow my dreams. And Tandi Zimu says, dreams turn into career. Thank you so much, guys, for all your comments. After the break, we're making a seafood curry, the perfect comfort food for the weekend. Welcome back to the Afternoon Express Kitchen. We're about to make a seafood curry.
Yeah.
I love seafood curry.
Really? Me too.
Yeah. Cool. So what's happening? I see there's some sea harvest.
Yes. We are making curry. So the first thing I've already done is I've fried my onion. And let's put it back. Okay.
Okay. So we just caramelize the onion.
Yes, basically. Let me not bend. Caramelize the onion. As you can see, it needs to be thoroughly cooked. Now, next thing is I put my garlic.
Okay.
And my ginger. Oh, yeah. Okay. You're going to stir for me,
so,
right?
So, Sibi, you basically fry the onion first, and yes, then when it's caramelized enough to your satisfaction, yes, then you add the garlic.
Add my garlic
in
and my...
Because you don't want to actually burn the garlic.
No, you don't want it to. Now, next is my chilies. It's curry, right? So.
Okay.
Let's do the chilies.
I love cooking in the loft. I mean, nothing looks as perfect when I'm making at home, but everything is looks it? So perfect here.
Well, it's a nice weather for the curry, so.
Even my stirring is perfect.
Okay, we add that, and is that fine?
Yes, okay. That's fine.
Now, the next thing we are gonna do is we're gonna add our spices, okay?
Okay.
Because what we wanna do is we wanna cook them thoroughly. So
okay.
Let's add that. This is mustard, coriander, all that. Okay, now
okay,
it needs to be thoroughly
so
cooked.
That was mustard?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So it needs, because we want that fragrant and we want our curry to be nice and the appearance-wise.
Yes.
Okay, so
yes,
now later we're gonna add the, okay, first let's start with the paste we have.
That's some tomato paste? Okay.
Yes.
Thank
we'll
you.
I'll add that. Already
right,
looking good, hey?
Yes, and it smells amazing.
Yeah. Okay, now, next thing, what we're gonna do is it cooking?
It's cooking,
okay.
Don't worry, I got it.
I'm gonna add the buttermilk, okay? Preferable use the buttermilk than other sauces, or like other milk or other liquid forms, because this gives it that nice texture and soft appearance. Okay.
Okay, so
I'm gonna add that. And
could you use coconut milk? I know you prefer that.
You can use coconut milk, cream. Actually. Yes, definitely. Okay. Look at that. Okay, you do that for like, you keep stirring, and preferably you leave it for longer, for like 20 minutes, because what we want to do is we want to cook it thoroughly
before
we actually add our seafood.
So for about 20 minutes it goes.
For about 20 minutes, okay. Mm-hmm. Now after that, we use seafood mix. Now I love this product because one, it's convenient, awesomeness, okay. Mm-hmm. Secondly, I like the fact that it's frozen, okay. Because it's convenient.
Yeah.
Think about it. If you did not take it, or let's say you're coming back from work and you really don't know
and
what to cook.
And you forgot to throw it.
It's perfect. It's perfect. You just put it in less than 5 minutes.
Yeah. And let's be honest. Every time you want to make some seafood, you can't rush out to a seafood market to find fresh seafood.
Yes.
Not
and
always.
This is. I love the fact that it's the quality of it. I'm a food lecturer, so I always tell my students that for you to get the end product right, you need to have quality ingredients.
Yes.
And so by doing that, this is awesome for me. Okay, so
while we're talking about how much we love Sea Harvest, there's a Sea Harvest competition happening on our Facebook page where you stand a chance to win 1,000 rand. So look out for that.
Okay. It's gonna come out nice. See, there's a little bit of everything here.
Awesome. So we just keep stirring.
Yes, keep stirring.
So with the ice and everything.
With the ice and everything, everything blends in together. We
because
normally
I'm sure
we'll
that ice has got flavor, hey?
Yes. We normally we're going to add water, so because it's frozen, that's perfect. So we don't really need that. But then if obviously it thickens, you can add more water to it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, cool. And that competition I mentioned just now, if you want to stand a chance of winning a Seafood Harvest kitchen hamper worth 1,000 Rand, head over to our Facebook page right now, Afternoon Express, and enter the competition post there. T's and C's apply.
Okay.
Right.
Okay, before that, I made the curry already, so we're going to take
that one.
Yes,
okay.
Okay.
Because we're on TV, we already have a ready-made one.
We're going to take that on the side. Just be careful. Switch it off.
Okay. Should we pass that to you?
I'll use that.
Ah!
Sorry. Okay, we have a seafood curry now. It comes up, it's nicer if you add with the coriander yogurt. So that's what we're going to do. We have a double thick yogurt here. Okay. Uh-huh. Now what we need to add is the
coriander.
The coriander.
Okay. Okay, so you add it to the yogurt.
Add it to the yogurt.
So we're doing yogurt and sour milk.
Were you doing yogurt inside, Richard?
So it won't be too sour?
No, it won't. Okay.
Okay, perfect.
Let's add a little bit of that and some. Put a little bit of cumin seed.
Cumin.
Yes. Okay, we're gonna add that. Let's mix that. Okay, can I have that? Okay.
Mix it up.
Mix it up because we're gonna mix it with that. Okay,
so
I'll take my leg.
After we've added that, how much longer do we cook for?
This, it's perfect as it is.
Oh, okay. So we're serving it with it,
we're
not adding.
We're serving it with that,
oh,
no.
Okay,
it comes,
okay.
It's gonna come perfectly
gotcha.
with the curry. Okay. Look how nice it is, the fragrance and the smell and everything. So put it here.
Dish it up nicely. Cool. It smells so amazing.
Okay. One more because it seems
all right. Perfect.
A lot of us.
Okay. That looks gorgeous. The keyword for this recipe is fish. SMS the keyword to 33650 for the ingredients and the recipe. And if you miss any of this delicious curry that we're making, check out this recap. Welcome back. I've been nibbling on Clem's bread. I've been very naughty. This looks absolutely amazing. I hope you're hungry, guys.
Yeah, it looks absolutely divine.
So I'm interested to know, what's going to happen with Kwezi in the future?
Well, currently we have it in stores, in exclusive bookstores nationwide. And obviously that's a big plus because more people get to access it, but definitely moving into animation.
Wow. And how frequently do you bring out the comic books?
So currently it's bi-monthly, but now that we've got that platform, we want to give the people that are collecting these books collector's editions. So it takes a lot longer, unfortunately, but you get so much more. You get 3 episodes per edition.
Wow. So maybe one day we'll look forward to seeing Kwezi in a movie.
Absolutely.
Absolutely amazing. So, Clem, what do you make of our curry that we've made?
I'm so impressed. You know what? I think that bread's going to be perfect with that curry.
Yeah.
To suck up
so.
All those sauces. Well done. Look at us all in salmon as well. Amazing.
That bread tastes so amazing. It's actually got a sweetness to it.
Mm. And a slight sourness from that yogurt as well. It's like sweet and sour at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So where are all your fashions available? Anyone watching and they'd like to get a hold of one of your designs, where can they find them?
We are available online, which is on Instagram at @orapelengmodutle and on Facebook, @orapelengmodutle. Mm-hmm. And we have a website, orapelengmodutle.com.
Awesome.
So people can come for us on there and then take it from there.
Okay, cool. Thank you so much for joining us today, guys.
Thank you.
Loved having you. So tomorrow on the show, it's all about women empowerment. We chat to news anchor and host of One Day Leader, Pearl Strongwe. Plus, we hear the inspiring story of a man who, after living on the streets, started a safe haven for women who are too old for foster care. We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place. Lots of love. Happy eating.
Coming up tomorrow on Afternoon Express, we chat to former Mrs. South Africa finalist Kerry Strubel, who started the Princess Boot Camp, an empowerment workshop for girls. So start your weekend off with Afternoon Express tomorrow at 5 p.m. on SABC3.
Another feel-good production.